What's up, guys? It's Ronnie here from Lake Hickory Scuba Marine. If you are new to our channel, do me a huge favor. Click this little subscribe button right here and ding that little bell as well. That way you guys will be notified every time we upload new content. Now, you guys have been asking for more Can We Dive It videos, and I got to apologize to you guys. We simply have just not had time to shoot those. Between doing all the salvage work that we do, running the marina, teaching, and just going on trips alone, we've not had time to really do much of anything. I've got a ton of review videos I've got to get up, and I hadn't even had time to shoot those as well. But today we're going to go out and do another Can We Dive It video, and we really hope you guys enjoy this. We had a private invite to a local quarry, and to our knowledge, no one has ever dove it. I don't even think it's been fished much, so we don't know what's in it. We don't even know how deep it is. And we're going to go out and explore it today, and we're going to see if it's going to be worth diving in the future. And if it is, we may even consider making an investment in it as a company, as a private quarry for our training center. But I've got to get down to the shop and meet up with some guys. And let me know down in the comment section below, do you think I should do this exploratory dive in side mount or back mount? I'm thinking to go a side mount just so that I can have extra cylinders with me, because I really don't know how deep this quarry is. If I had to guess, most of the quarries here in our area are 100 foot or less. But with that being said, I think I'm going to probably go to a side mount just so that I've got the extra gas and I'll have a little bit more freedom to explore stuff if I need to. But let me know down in the comment section below, what should I do, back mount or side mount on this dive? All right, guys, I'm going to give you a little background about the quarry that we're at. This is about 10 miles from our shop, and it's kind of on the backside of a farm area. Kind of go up a little mountain area, and when you get to the backside of that property, you come across this quarry here. This was a private invite that we got, and the owner just wanted us to basically see what was under the water, see how deep it was. There's a lot of stories about this quarry that there's bodies in it, there's cars in it, and that it's about 100 foot deep. So that's what we're doing here today. We're going out to explore and just see what we can find, see how deep it is, see what's located in it, see what the visibility is, and if things work out for the best, we are considering maybe working with the owner to get a lease to possibly use this as training grounds. But as you can see here, now I am going to jump around a little bit. You're actually seeing it from one of the other divers' perspectives. So you're going to see me on camera. You'll see him on camera. You'll see my dad on camera, who's also diving with us in this video. But you're going to see it from a couple of different perspectives. This is from one of our instructors' perspective. He's got a camera mounted to his helmet there. And we're just swimming along. Now, it is very dark here. There's not a lot of light that's penetrating, not necessarily because the visibility is just bad. It's just there's so much grass here, and as we're kind of swimming around, and we're actually going to surface several times, but as we're swimming around, we're noticing that there's really no good area to maybe put platforms or anything like that, because it's just solid grass. Now, we do have hard bottom, which is a good thing. The silt that we found was, say, less than 2 inches deep for the entire quarry, and it's rock up underneath that, so that's a good thing, but there's no solid ground that doesn't have grass in it, so we'd actually have to get in here and move a lot of this grass, which you'll see a little bit later in the video. We'd have to move a lot of that grass out of the way just for us to actually put things here on the bottom. But we are basically just going to do two cross sections of the quarry. We're going to start at one side, go across, and then we'll pop up to the top and kind of move at a 90 degree angle and then cut across again. So imagine that round quarry just having a cross going through the center of it. But here you can kind of see the bottom there. It is silty, so if you touch it, it is going to stir it up, but it's solid rock underneath it. And that 2 inches of silt's what's holding all this grass in here. And you're going to see here in just a minute how much grass there actually is that we're having to swim through. There you can kind of see the grass is already wrapped around me. That's me on the left side of the screen there in side mount. And it looks like I'm flying with a cape on. That's just literally just swimming through the grass. That's how much I collected as I swam through it. Now, the maximum depth here, of course, is about 14 feet was the deepest part that we could find. And I basically had to bury my computer down in the seal. But it's kind of funny. When I come up, my dad was kind of laughing at me there, telling me I was looking like the swamp creature or swamp thing. But that's basically what's in this quarry here, is just solid grass. A little bit of silt on top of the rock, but it's not very deep. It's only about 14 foot deep. Visibility, in all honesty, we had maybe 4 foot in a good area, a lot less in the bad areas there. There was some wildlife. We had quite a few brim and bass and things like that swimming along. But outside of that, we didn't really see much. I'm sure there's turtles in here and frogs in here and, of course, snakes. I mean, you're on farmland. You're going to have a lot of that in there. But we didn't really see anything that would be out of the ordinary. Now, that grass that you're looking at that we're swimming through now, that's about 5 to 6 foot tall. So if you extended it all the way up, it's very tall grass that we're swimming through. Now, this next little bit is a little concerning to us as I'm just playing around in the grass. This is actually where I was reaching down to see how deep I could get. I actually come across some bones, and at first glance you would just think, well, it's animal bones, but what I'm actually going to do here is I'm actually going to mark the area with an SMB, and I'm going to kind of compile the bones up, and then we're going to do a little research after this video just to find out what they are. Can I say they're human bones? I don't know. What I can say is it is a femur bone, and it is a hip bone. Now, if it's a human bones or a human skeleton that we come across down here, then it's a child. It's not going to be an adult just because of how small it is. But I personally don't believe it's that. I believe it could be a pig bone, maybe a coyote or something like that, that another animal had drug out there. But there was a pile of bones down there. We're going to mark it, and there you can kind of see the hip bone I'm bringing up, and you'll see the femur bone too. But as I'm bringing them up, we're going to kind of mark that area just so that we've got it documented what it is and where it was found. But we're going to go ahead and end this dive because there wasn't really much left there. It was just these bones and a lot of grass. All right, guys, so I hope you enjoyed the Can We Dive It series again. We're going to try to bring these back. We have a lot of fun going out and exploring new areas. Even if it's a cruddy old quarry like this, we just enjoy getting out there and seeing what's underneath it. So we're hoping to bring this series back and at least film several more of these for you this year. And we've actually sent those bones off to see exactly what they are. To be honest with you, I don't think they're human remains, but who knows? But guys, if you did like the video, give me a big thumbs up. Definitely share it as well. If you got any questions, please put it down in the comment section below. As always, make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Like us on Facebook. Pin us on Pinterest. Subscribe to us here on YouTube. And as always, guys, we appreciate your business.